Good morning and greetings to you all, wherever you are joining us from all over the world. Know that God is with you wherever you are. Today is Sunday, the 19th day of July, 2020. And I call us to worship God together in the beauty of His holiness. Rejoice in Jesus Christ, the beauty of God. We sing of the one who clothes us with joy. Rejoice in Jesus Christ, the light of salvation. We sing and worship the one who wraps us in grace. Rejoice in Jesus Christ, the hope of new life. We worship the one who blesses us with hope. Rejoice in Jesus Christ, the one who is here. We worship the Christ, God's love in our midst. Let us worship God. Let us pray. Lord our God, we come into your presence with praise. We come before you with joy and gladness. You are our God. You are the source of all that we know, of truth and beauty, of mercy and justice, of wisdom and righteousness, and goodness and love. We come into your presence with awe and reverence because you are holy. Father, as we behold your majesty, we bow before you in adoration and worship. Lord God, you have loved us, and in grace you have made us your people. But we confess before you now that we have sinned. We confess our secret sins that remain hidden from others, and our open sins that are known to many. We confess the sins which lie heavy in our hearts, and the sins which no longer trouble us because our hearts has become hardened. We confess that we have not loved one another as Christ has loved us, nor have we forgiven one another as he has forgiven us. Through the death of Jesus Christ, our Savior, Lord, forgive us, we pray. Spirit of the living God, you are to us the guarantee that we shall receive all that has been promised to us. Your presence with us is indeed the stamp of ownership upon our lives, assuring us that we are God's people and that we shall come eventually into that perfect freedom he has promised us in Christ. Fill our hearts this morning as we worship with your presence. May your word enrich our lives. This we ask through Jesus Christ, who taught us when we pray to say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, here on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who have sinned against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Genesis chapter 28 verses 10 to 19, Jacob's dream at Bethel. Jacob left Beersheba and set out for Haran. When he reached a certain place, he stopped for the night because the sun had set. Taking one of the stones there, he put it under his head and lay down to sleep. He had a dream in which he saw a stairway resting on the earth, with its top reaching to heaven, and the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. There above it stood the Lord, and he said, I am the Lord, the God of your father Abraham, and the God of Isaac. I will give you and your descendants the land on which you are lying. Your descendants will be like the dust of the earth, and you'll spread out to the west and to the east, to the north and to the south. All peoples on earth will be blessed through you and your offspring. I am with you and will watch over you wherever you go, and I will bring you back to this land. I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you. When Jacob awoke from his sleep, he thought, surely the Lord is in this place, and I was not aware of it. He was afraid and said, how awesome is this place! This is none other than the house of God. This is the gate of heaven. Early the next morning, Jacob took the stone he had placed under his head and set it up as a pillar and poured oil on top of it. He called that place Bethel, though the city used to be called Luz. And may God add his blessing to this reading from his holy word.
Let us prepare our hearts to hear the word of God. Jesus says, "Lo, I am with you always, to the very end of ages." Let us pray. O God, the strength of the souls that seek you, direct our thinking and our speaking and our hearing through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. God is with you is our theme this morning. But let me ask you, has God ever appeared to you? God appeared to Jacob and blesses him and makes him the inheritance of the promises of Abraham and Isaac, and to give him the unchanging promise that he would bless him. This was shortly after he has deceived his brother Esau and taken his blessings that Jacob began his trip to Haran, following his mother's instruction. He stopped to rest for the night at a place called Bethel. He laid his head on a rock and went to sleep. While he was sleeping, he had a dream in which he saw a ladder connecting heaven and earth, and the angels of God were ascending and descending, as it were. There above it stood the Lord, and he said, "I am the Lord, the God of your father Abraham, and the God of Isaac. I will give you and your descendants the land on which you are lying. Your descendants will be like the dust of the earth, and you will spread out to the west and to the east, to the north and to the south. All peoples of the earth shall be blessed through you and your offspring. I am with you and will watch over you wherever you go, and I will bring you back to this land. I will not leave you until I have done what I have promised you." This is what we saw from our reading this morning from Genesis chapter 28. God is always present, regardless of where you found yourself. He is Jehovah Shammah, which means the Lord is there. He was with Jacob. He was with Joseph from the pit to prison, and from prison to become the prime minister in a strange land. He was with Daniel in the lion's den. He was with the three Hebrew men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, in the fire of Nebuchadnezzar. Never a time in history has he abandoned anyone that put his or her trust in him. as you are challenged day by day. The circumstances and the problems of life throw you here and there. God is there. When you feel all alone, God is there. When you don't know what is happening to you, God is there. Not only is God always there, God watches over you. He pays attention to every detail, everything that is happening to you. When God says that He is watching over you, it means that He is not only watching over you, but He is also acting on your behalf. God told Jacob that He will bring him back to that land, the land of Bethel, where he lay that night. Later in Jacob's life, God changed his name to Israel, as we see in Genesis 35. You can read that Jacob returned to live in Bethel as God has promised. But the promise was also fulfilled in the nation of Israel when God returned the slavery in Egypt. It was also fulfilled later when a remnant of the nation of Israel returned from their exile in Babylon. God has never failed in any of His promises. It is always His good pleasure to be with us. However, the ultimate fulfillment of His promise to be with us is found in the birth of Jesus Christ. The scripture says, "Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bring forth a child, and they shall call his name Emmanuel," which means God with us. After the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, and before his ascension to heaven, he said to his followers, "And behold, I am with you always, to the end of the age." When Jesus ascended into heaven, the Holy Spirit descended upon God's people, a sign that God is always with his people. He watches over us. He keeps us. He's a loving Father. But did you know that Jesus referred to this dream of Jacob when he chose his apostles, his disciples? When Philip brought Nathanael to Jesus, Jesus said to him, "Behold, an Israelite indeed, in whom there is no deceit." Nathanael said to him, "How did you know me?" Jesus answered him, "Before Philip called you, when you were under the fig tree, I saw you." Nathanael was amazed and answered him, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." Jesus smiled at him and said to him, "Truly, truly, I say to you, you will see heaven open and the angels of God ascending and descending on the Son of Man." Here is Jacob's dream in Jesus' lips. Heaven opened, and the angels of God ascending and descending. But notice, the ladder was missing. The angels are ascending and descending upon the Son of Man. That is Jesus. Jesus is saying that himself is the ladder. He is the link between heaven and earth, as Jesus will later claim in John and say, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." Jesus is the way to God. Jesus is the mediator. No one comes to the Father except through Jesus Christ. He connects heaven and earth. Jesus is the ladder to heaven. So let us believe that the only way to God is through Jesus. Let us trust Jesus, and we will discover that he will be with us wherever we go and in every situation that we found ourselves. He has promised that he will never leave us nor abandon us. So when you walk through fire, God is there with you. When you walk through water, God is there with you. When the storm pulls you up and down, God is there with you. Let this be your hope, that God never leaves you, and he will always strengthen you and keep you in all your ways. Amen. Let us pray. Now to God of all ages, who has called us to his eternal glory in Christ Jesus, be the power forever. Amen.
Above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man, you were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. Before the world. rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground. You took the fall and thought of me above all. Crucified, lay behind the star. You live to die, rejected and
we just thank you that we can come together in this way during this time of lockdown. We thank you for the church family, for the support that it is and has been for each of us. Lord, we pray for those who are bereaved at this time or ill, and we just thank you that you are with them. Lord, help them feel your presence. Lord, we pray for the wider church family in our parish, that they would, when the doors open, know about Stanley and know that there is something new and exciting happening in our building, and that that would raise some interest and that people would want to know more about you through us. We pray for the wider presbytery of Ayr, and for any complications or situations that are happening within the presbytery, Lord, we just ask that at all times the focus would be on you and your work. There would be no politics in it. And to that end, Lord, we pray for our government, for our local councils, for the worldwide governments, especially at this time, Lord, when people are having to make decisions based on science. Let it be so. Let your will be done. Lord, we pray for families during this time of lockdown and the school holidays that are not quite what they would have been in previous years. Let them just have patience with each other, Lord. Let us have patience with each other and know your love and care. Lord, and as schools and workplaces get ready to go back to normal, we are unsure of what normal is, but Lord, you know. Lord, we pray that you will bring wisdom to all the politicians, to all the decision makers, to the sessions, to one-to-one, in the way that things will start to go back to a new normal. And Lord, we just thank you for all that you do in each of our lives. Lord, help us to stay close to you. Help us to remember to read your word, to speak to you, to share with others your word, no matter where we are or what we are doing. Lord, we thank you for all the organisations out there who throughout COVID have been working away, helping others. And I particularly think of 1010 and thank you for the work that they are doing. And in line with our vision and the church sharing the love of Jesus. Lord, help us as we come back together to know how we can share the love with Jesus in our own community and in our parish. Lord, we ask you all these things in your most precious name. Amen.
Of Jesus the Nazarene, and wonder how he could love. sorrows, He made them His very own. He bore the burdens in Calvary and suffered and died alone. How marvelous, how wonderful, and my song shall ever be. How marvelous, how wonderful is my Savior's love for me. When with the ransomed in glory, His face I at last shall see.
Joining us in today's service. I trust you have been blessed with the assurance that God is with you in any and every situation you found yourself. He never sleeps, He never slumbers. He watches over you both day and night. Go now with the love of Christ our Lord. May God be with you in all that you do. May He never leave you nor forsake you, now and forever. Amen. I want to remind you again that soon we will gather here in this sanctuary to continue our service and worship to God. And I want you to understand that God has a purpose in everything that happens to us. He has a plan, and He is working out a blessing for you, for me, for all of us. So join us next Sunday as we worship God together again. God bless you.